written by a student at our college. And type of filming of the play, so go ahead and do that. Thank you so much.
Lila, a honeykeeper, the Dazi Bob, a Kanwa Kage. Long ago, mighty bow was created. Zizi Skopola is the bow which grants the power to defeat any foe. Before the stories of the heroes that have used this bow, this is the story of the bow itself. Itajipa, Uhe, Uchoyake Ki, Echa, Bowana. There was once a Wuchasha named Zizi who existed in the land of the star people, the world in a different plane of existence than the one we live in as humans. In this world, the grass is tall, and the world is bountiful and always full of life. Zizi was a Wuchasha who grew up fascinated with the flute songs of the Heako Oyate, the Alp Nation. As a child, he would wander towards their songs in the west, where the sun would rise, for the color of this morning star shining in his eyes. He was given the name Zizi.
I really love the Elk songs.
And I ain't gonna lie, they are pretty bitch.
Zizi asked if he could learn these songs. The Heako Oyate allowed him to. As the teaching goes, it was the Elk Nation who brought the flute to the Lakota Oyate. But this was long before that time. Zizi listened intently and learned these songs quickly and skillfully. Zizi became curious about what to use these songs for.
Zizi, these songs, they are very powerful. You must remember to use them very responsibly, and not in a bad way, but most important, use them with responsibility.
So what if I use this responsibly?
Oh, Taya, you know, carry it well.
And if using it in a bad way, isn't it bad just a concept to the individual?
It's easy.
Alright, I get it. Stay home.
ZZ had always known that the world he lived in was a more bountiful reflection of another world, our world. But he had never had interest in our world below, until he came across a hole in the ground. In the land of the star people, nobody picked the Timsila, wild prairie turnips, because it would open a portal to the earth below. Zizi did not know why someone picked this Timsila, but when he saw the world below, he saw someone in danger. He was Waniomi, the little whirlwind, the youngest brother of the four winds of the four directions. Waniomi was being chased by Iak, the giant devourer. Zizi knew that the power of the Heako Oyate stood to save the little whirlwind Waniomi, so he made his choice. Through the portal, he bowed very high from the sky. He wasn't expecting this. In fact, probably should have packed some extra chones or something.
My chones.
Zizi readied his stance for a heroic landing and... At least as he awoke, he did have a plan. He would use the Heako Oyate's flute to put the giant Ia to sleep.
Makiayo! Makiayo! Ia is chasing me!
Okay, will this help?
Actually, no. No, it won't.
Yeah, help me!
serious. We all came to help. Gulig fall over the head. Now ZZ was able to play a song at the foot of the cliff. With this song, ZZ was able to will the ER to fall asleep. Wanyomi was saved, but ZZ did not know who this mysterious Weon was.
I really don't know who this mysterious Weon is.
You know what? I believe it. You're actually pretty fast, and Eon couldn't even catch you. But, me? ZZ and Machi up below.
Huh. It's nice to meet you, ZZ.
Yeah, it's nice to meet you, too. Oh, hey, by the way, did you ever hear that song I played a bit ago? No, I made that song. It only took me about 10 minutes. It took me about 2 minutes. No, but on the real, I made it on the spot. Off top of the dome.
It was a beautiful song, but I was really more surprised that you fell from the sky just to help your good friend.
Actually, I don't even know this guy, and to be honest, he was...
Anyways, you know, us star people, we like to be humble, so... Enough of the compliments, please.
You came from the stars? Yeah! That is very beautiful. You know, I can sense that there's something special within you, even among the star people, with a great purpose. You know, I think I will see you again, ZZ. Doksha.
Dang, sure. Gee, bro, she's really fast. I think she's awesome.
Uh-huh. I think her power is connected with the wind somehow. Anyway, speaking of the winds, here come my brothers, the Four Winds.
The Tateo Topa. The Four Winds were impressed of ZZ's effort to save their little brother. They thanked ZZ and decided that they will honor him. Yukbe, the West Wind, leader of the brothers, addressed him.
You have saved your little brother. And we wish to put our trust in you and to give you a power. Each of us has placed our power into the making of this bow, which is Moka, the potential to give life and to take away. You are responsible for using this for the benefit of the people. Please bestow this.
ZZ Skopula.
Now, it will be known as... Wait, what? ZZ Skopula? Like a banana? The Four Winds have placed their power into this, and you're gonna name it Banana?
Yep.
Oh. ZZ Skopula. Ichiapi Katelo.
ZZ didn't understand the kind of power he held, or what to use it for. But he wandered on the earth and the little whirlwind tagged along just as curious.
ZZ, what kind of power did my brothers give you? I want to see it, what is it?
Actually, I don't even know. In fact, it looks like a, some kind of plain old bowl. But, it does look like Rosebud would use this in the AAC tournament for archery. Nah, actually, this is better than that. There ain't even duct tape on it.
Duct tape? Slowly, Ashley. I don't even know what that is. Anyhow, I think my brother said you need to use it for something responsible. So, let's go visit the people first.
Why do you only guide his ZZ? And they met the people. The people were amazed at his presence. Especially with the fact that the whirlwind Wanyomi was a companion traveling with him.
Yeah, I know this bow is cool and all because I control the whirlwind, but you know, my very own power is special. What I mean to say is, help me out, you guys. call me. It's actually nice to see you.
You brought your good friend with you.
I wouldn't say good.
I don't know if I'd say friend.
Oh, well, we welcome you, and we thank you for coming here today. Our people, they need your help. With me, I will tell you about the monster.
The people live near a great river. They were being terrorized by monsters created by the evil spirit and family. This time, she had created a serpent, which had been eating all the people. They weren't able to live their lives near the river. They could not even retrieve water. With the bow, ZZ Smokey already. ZZ and Wanyomi ventured towards the lake and waited it out. The serpent struck. They narrowly escaped being eaten. ZZ aimed ZZ Smokey at the serpent, drew back the string and...
Damn, we ain't got no arrows.
The bow destroyed the serpent and blew a hole through the land, making a canyon and a new river.
We need all this, sir. It's astonishing.
See, you made it safe for our people to live near the river again. Goodbye, my God.
ZZ told Luzahalki, or actually vowed, that he would return to see her again. He also told her that it's a star people's belief that if you show up to your village with a somewhat annoying little whirlwind and a bow created by the four winds and destroys a serpent, it implies for a romantic connection blessed by the cycle of the stars. Yeah, it was super specific. I don't know where he got it from or if it's true.
Oh, it's true. I was told that by a star person a long time ago. I think it was some kind of wise elder's star knowledge dude.
Ah, thank you for sharing this great teaching with me from the elder star knowledge dude. But we thank you for coming to help us today. You know, it was good to see you,
Cece. So too.
The people were grateful, but downstream, many lives were changed by ZZ's new river taking water away from the river they once knew. ZZ and Wanyomi kept traveling. This time, they came upon the Shubila Oyate, the Fox Nation, who were being terrorized by a gigantic Shimani Tutanka, the Neshkia. This was a giant wolf possessed by the power of the evil spirit, the Neshkia. ZZ accepted the mission to destroy it. And so he and Wanyomi took a wander through the woods. They heard noises and caught glimpses of something dashing by.
It's over there.
The Shimani Tutanka dodged the shot. Though it was large, it was quick and hid well, moving in the woods.
ZZ, he's too fast. He's told me we cannot do it.
What? What was that? Sorry, I can't hear you over the edge, Dushni.
See, but ZZ was becoming overconfident, knowing how powerful his bow was. ZZ drew ZZ Skopula and took shot after shot, leveling the forest down until the demon wolf had nowhere to hide. After the forest was clear, the demon wolf ran straight at ZZ. And ZZ hit it with the power of the four winds, destroying it. The Shingila Ayate, the Fox Nation, were grateful. Yet ZZ's recklessness caused many hardship for living beings who lived in the forest. ZZ had become more arrogant. He announced to the nations that his power is the greatest, that he is the true power that can bring order to the land. ZZ, return to see Lusa Halloween. During a dark, stormy day, he wanted to give her a sunny day. So he shot ZZ Scopola into the sky, using the wind to part the clouds. What ZZ had done did create a beautiful sunny day, but the parted clouds were pushed out of the riddle and formed a tornado far away. ZZ did not know it, but the original storm with ZZ shot was sent by the Thunder Nation, the Waki'a Oyate. It was intended to drive back the evil spirits and bring balance back to the land. Now, the people were in even greater danger as a tornado approached. ZZ stood before the storm and aimed ZZ Scopola at the tornado. When he shot directly at the tornado storm, it was cut through the middle and split into two directions, splitting away to miss the village. The village called him a hero once again. But Lusa Halloween had a feeling something was still wrong and wanted to check on nearby nations. She was right. Splitting the storm doubled its strength and power in its new past. Those in the way of his new past were in even greater danger. With the Waki'a Oyate's thunderstorm split apart, now the evil spirits of Dewi and her sons, the giant devourer Ia and Kanishkia, were all happy to thrive in the absence of the Thunder Nation's storm. Even Igdomi, the trickster, agreed to work with them. For his love of chaos and trickery, he changed himself into a wolf and met with ZZ.
How great hero! Thank you for saving us from my relative who is possessed by Daily's evil spirit. We would love to honor you.
You say, honor?
Yes, I did.
Will there be food?
Yes, there will be. Bring your Watecha containers.
So, by the way, what do you guys even do at honorings? I picture wolves having like star quilts, commodities, the gold brick. You think even a dream catcher with a wolf on it?
Yes, do you want to be a gift?
Well, I mean, I am kind of a gift to the world, aren't I?
Yes, a very strong macaw man you are. How, let me show you the way.
I don't even know why that dude was disguised as a wolf. Anyways, who's this lady?
Udevi, Hemie. I am Udevi. You have cleared the path of the Waki'a Oyate storm and made it possible for me to come out onto the land further than I've been than many years. For that, I want to say Plamiaye.
Well, it's what I do. It's being really, really super.
Foolish, overconfident. You have harmed many nations. I like what you do, but all I want is your power. Give me your bow, power of the four winds.
to. And I was given power by the four winds to be a messenger among the nations. But they trusted you with even greater power. I always knew that there was something special about you. I think my time here as a messenger is over. It was nice to meet you, Sissy. But I wish I could hear you play the flute.
Dishonor her love for creation, for my sake of vengeance.
This is impossible. Love is not this true. Michinchi, Ia, my other son, the devourer, come. Eat them all! Won't die yet!
In the land. Please help. Makiayo Ushimalayo. Please help me. It's not even working. What's so calm about it?
I can't hear the sound of the chapter's name. The sound of you being wrong.
Your spirit is Wampa, the spark of life. You go free from the Gnashkia because you're not me. Knows the true power of love, of life.
Yukbe asked ZZ to become the bow ZZ Scopola and give his life to save Luzahali.
I'll do it.
You become the bow. We will save Ujahomi from Uthneri, and we will appeal the creator, Taku Shkashkam, and we will place her spirit in the land of the star people.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Let's do this.
And we'll see her again someday.
ZZ accepted. He now became ZZ Scopola, to where he would benefit all relations of the universe, to where it may take hundreds or thousands of years for him to complete his task. So, ZZ, now known as ZZ Scopola, became a spirit in another plane of being, not visible on the earth, and not visible in the land of the star people, waiting for the next adventure, to be called upon by a worthy hero. ZZ Scopola is somewhere out there, somewhere beyond, out, or in. ZZ Scopola, Nielo. Every plane of being is connected, and even what you cannot see is still connected to you.